This is Lian Li's new flagship all-in-one CPU cooler that's designed to merge high-class features with fans that balance beauty and bling. Now, we're gonna tell you all about the potential pain points and the possibilities of this premium CPU cooler right here, right now on Robeytech, right after a word from our sponsor. If you've just built or upgraded your PC and now that Windows watermark just saying activate Windows is just sitting in your face, don't panic. VIP-CDKDeals.com is here to help. VIP-CDKDeals offers legitimate software activation keys at a fraction of the retail price. We're talking deep discounts on Windows 10 and 11, home and pro versions, plus Microsoft Office, Steam keys, and so much more. You can even use code RBCK at checkout for an additional 30% off. Check out VIP-CDKDeals.com today and get back to enjoying your PC without that watermark. It wasn't that long ago that we reviewed the mid-range option from Lian Li's HydroShift II lineup, the HydroShift II LCD-C360R, which was actually just rebranded as the 360CL. Whatever the name of it is at this second, we were impressed enough that we had to see what the flagship version brought to the table. Not only that, but we also wanted to answer the burning question on all of our minds. Is it worth spending the extra moolah on the flagship with its more powerful fans? Visually, the two coolers are very similar, which is a good thing if you're a fan of Lian Li's aesthetic. And the 360 TL definitely brings the eye candy with the HydroShift II's customizable LCD screen and the infinity mirrors and RGB strips of the UniFan TL fans. There's a sense of intentionality here we've come to love about Lian Li, and this bad boy is all about turning your system into a showstopper with the least effort possible from DIY builders. But here's the thing, where the 360 CL occupies the middle of this line of coolers, the 360 TL shifts into pole position with a set of high-performance fans that promise better temps. So we should see some improvements in performance here, right? Well, there is a catch with this one, and the story of the cooler is a little more complicated than we anticipated. And believe us when we say that there are important details with this one that you should know if you're considering picking one up for yourself. Now, we're gonna spill the tea, but before we do, we'd like to thank Lian Li for supplying us a sample of the HydroShift II LCD-C360TL for us to do this review today. So let's get to know the HydroShift II TL, starting with the DL on its pricing and available options. As I mentioned earlier in this video, this cooler comes in a handful of different versions, but all of their radiators are 360 millimeters in size. The TL we have today sits at the top, the king of performance and pricing hill, and will set you back $230 to $240 depending on where you buy it from. The 360 CL and the 360N are next in this lineup, with the CL model and its RGB focus fans costing $180, while the 360N is a strictly bring your own fans version for only $160. All three models offer the same highlights, including a customizable 2.1 inch 480 by 480 resolution screen, pre-routed braided cables that, yes, lock you to a top-mounted orientation, but they look so clean out of the box. This display has two different control modes, so you can dial it in with your motherboard or use Lian Li's L-Connect 3 software. With a price that's so much higher than the virtually identical 360 CL, the TL has something to prove. Against the CL, yes, but its price also puts it in direct competition with performers like the ASUS ProArt LC360 or the similarly priced PC cooler DT360 with its larger 3.4 inch screen. But now that we know how much the HydroShift II 360 TL will cost to call your own, how simple is it to get settled into its new home inside of your PC? For Intel users, it mounts LGA 1851 and LGA 1700 sockets, so it's compatible back to Intel's 12th generation all the way to its current Intel line of Core Ultra 200S processors. As for AMD, there's support for both AM4 and AM5 sockets. That includes more processors thanks to AMD's longer support for its sockets since the release of Ryzen, but for you, it means that as long as you're using a Ryzen CPU, you're good to go. Installation, however, is a bit of a mixed bag and has some quirks that new and seasoned builders will want to pay attention to. Like we saw with the HydroShift II 360 CL, the TL again uses a mounting bracket that requires you to slide the pump head into place. But while this might sound better than some other options out there like AMD's hook and latch system, which this replaces, it requires you to hold the pump head millimeters above the CPU without smearing thermal paste or accidentally scratching your cold plate, neither of which are ideal. One of its brackets is also right underneath the tubing, so it's possible to miss the latch without realizing, creating poor contact between the IHS and the cold plate, which could cause your system to overheat and leave new builders kind of scratching their heads and wonder what went wrong with their life. We're probably making this sound worse than it is. I'm guessing we're being a little overdramatic, but here's the deal. There is room for error, so we need to bring it up, especially if you're a new builder or you're speed running your build. While we're on topic of getting the 360 TL pump settled into a new home on your motherboard, let's take a closer look at how it actually functions. The pump has a rated RPM range of 2000 to 2500 with a 10% variance up or down. On our sample, we found the top speed to be 2600 RPM, which fits the variance, but was also cleanly pegged at 2600 RPM. Now the radiator is slightly thinner than the usual with a 24 millimeter thickness instead of 25 millimeters to 27 millimeters. Lian Li also managed to shave a touch from its length, bringing it to an even 400 millimeters total, but it's still a few millimeters longer than many of its competitors. But when it comes to what sets this AiO apart, the 360 TL's Lian Li UniFan TL fans are really the star of the show here. Not only are they just plain pretty fans, they're a bit on the larger side with a thickness of 28 millimeters compared to the standard 25 millimeters of most 120 millimeter fans. That extra depth helps provide more airflow and higher pressure to force air through the thinner radiator. Spec-wise, the TL fans have a rated speed range of 200 to 2600 RPM, an airflow rating of 90.1 CFM, and a 3.97 millimeter H2O of static pressure. Compared to the HydroShift II 360 CL, that's an improvement of 25% in total airflow and 32% in higher static pressure. And while the 360 TL is pressing air through the radiator, why don't you go ahead and press that like and subscribe button below the video and ring the notification bell so you're the first to know about our next video. And for more great tech content, do the same over at Robeytech Live. You're gonna be really glad that you did. Now that we know what's happening inside, let's look at what's happening outside with its LCD screen. Now the 360 TL comes with a 2.1 inch IPS display with a 480 by 480 resolution. For its size, its picture is crisp and won't leave jagged edges on the memes and the GIFs you upload with Lian Li's L-Connect 3 software. Animations are smooth thanks to its 60 Hz refresh rate, and the picture is nice and bright with a rated peak brightness of 500 nits. Now, if you want deeper levels of control, you can then install Lian Li's L-Connect 3 software. This software includes the expected abilities to control lighting options and performance modes. So the HydroShift 2 gives you two methods of controlling what's on the screen, but remember the catch I talked about in the beginning? This is where things get interesting. If you want the pump to run at full speed, L-Connect is a requirement, but more importantly, if you want the motherboard to control it, you still have to have L-Connect set up so you can change the default setting to hand over control to the motherboard instead of using the software. Now in our testing, we found that even though L-Connect reported the pump running at 100%, when we looked at the actual RPMs, it was actually running about 10% slower than it should have been. That being said, Lian Li does disclose that the actual speed of the pump could be 10% higher or lower than the listed speed. For context, 10% is about 200 RPM, and that's enough to make a measurable difference in cooling performance. Is this concerning? Well, that all depends on who you are. To be honest, we all hope that the products we get match or exceed the specs on paper, but there is always slight variances in products, which is why there's a such thing as a golden sample. That being said, this could just be an issue that Lian Li can address in a future software update. For now, we can only review what we have, just be aware that this might show up when we look at the data. And now that we know how to get the HydroShift 2 360L to reach its top speeds, let's see finally how it performs. As a reminder, all of our benchmarking is done on nearly identical test PCs for AMD and Intel. Details on screen for specs, but they're all done under the same conditions for apples to apples comparisons. We're gonna go through the results quickly, so feel free to pause the video for a closer look at the number. Starting with Intel, at idle, the HydroShift 360 TL landed at the warmer side of our charts with an average of just below 31 degrees Celsius. This places the TL next to the Arctic Liquid Freezer 3 ARGB and the Trikes Panorama SE. Not an amazing start, but also not dangerous. Moving on to CPU load test, the HydroShift 360 TL fell squarely in the middle of the pack with an average temp just below 84 degrees Celsius, which was incredibly close to the 360 CL during its turn in the hot seat. As for the TL's nearest price competitors, the ASUS ProArt LC was marginally better at around 83 degrees, and the PC Cooler DT360 beat them both on an average temperature just shy of 80 degrees. For gaming, things didn't get better from a thermal perspective. In our roster of tests, the TL averaged just under 59 degrees Celsius, the same test that the 360 CL averaged 57 degrees in. This positioned it in between the Dark Flash DH360D, which we'll be reviewing shortly, and the Liquid Freezer 3 ARGB. Turning to our Cinebench and our thermal stress test, the HydroShift 2 360 TL finished with an average score of 33,432 and landed right in the middle of the results, topping the 360 CL by about 100 points. Power draw tells a pretty interesting story though. In our test, the TL allowed our Intel CPU to pull an average of around 245 watts under load and smack in between 107 and 108 watts when gaming. Remember, temperatures are a byproduct of power draw here. While the temps are higher, so is the level of juice the rig is pulling. Turning to our AMD bench, the 360 TL continued to be kind of a mixed bag. At idle, the TL found itself at the warmest part of our charts again, with an average just above 42 degrees Celsius. The Liquid Freezer 3 ARGB did keep it company here, so it wasn't entirely alone. For low testing, the TL averaged just under 89 degrees Celsius, keeping it in the same relative position compared to the competition. For Cinebench, it dropped to second to last place with a score of 19,476. Granted, there isn't a whole lot of variance here. As for power draw here, the TL averaged right in between 144 and 145 watts under load, which was right in the middle of the pack. As for gaming, we saw the TL average just below 57 degrees Celsius in our thermal test, while drawing an average wattage below 77 watts while gaming. Just like with Intel, if gaming is your goal, the TL will get the job done and look good doing it. As a reminder, I know it's easy to look at these charts as pass and fail, but it's worth remembering that none of these temperatures are high enough to put your system or its performance at risk at all. This will do more than an adequate job of cooling any enthusiast level CPU. Before moving on to value, there's one more data point, and that's noise level. We measured the HydroShift II LCD-C360 TL at just below 48 decibels with the fans during our gaming benchmarks and around 64 decibels under full load. That's on the quieter side for what we've seen, and it puts it right at the level of an average room when you're at home alone. Now, with all the data on the table, let's look at the relative value before we share our opinion on this AIO. Here's the fancy math. We divide the MSRP by the difference between CPU thermal max, which is 100 degrees Celsius, and then the average CPU temperature under load. This gives us a dollars per degree of cooling value, which we can then score and compare. In this case, the lower the better. These numbers are based on what data we collect from our Intel benchmarks and the MSRP pricing. These values will change over time, but you have the equation if you want a more up-to-date value. Using these calculations, the HydroShift 360 TL comes in with a relative value of 14.7, putting it towards the bottom of our ranking list and out of the realm of cost conscious. While it's not exorbitantly expensive, its value proposition makes it less economical for its cooling performance, unless you're looking for cool points versus cooling points. With all that in mind, would we recommend the HydroShift II 360 TL? When it comes to the performance, the TL clearly has room for growth. Compared to the HydroShift II 360 CL or R or whatever Lian Li changes it to, the TL doesn't seem to offer the kind of games we would expect from its higher price and higher performance fans, unless you're factoring in how cool the infinity mirrors are and RGB on the fans look. So what's happening here? While we can't say with 100% confidence all the reasons why the TL may not be performing better, we don't think it's because of the fans. As we dug into the performance in our testing lab, we actually removed the fans and tried them on another AIO, and you know what? They performed great and cooled just as well as we'd hoped they would. So it's kind of inconclusive. Is it the pump speed? Is it the cold plate? Is it the thinner radiator? Is it something else? In all likelihood, it's kind of a combination. What makes this so head-scratchingly confounding is that we're not even sure if L-Connect is reporting the right speeds or if something is getting lost in translation between the software and the PWM controls. We even went back to retest everything, and the differences in our test range anywhere from 1 to 4 degrees higher temps, which is no small distinction. With all that said, is the HydroShift II 360 TL going to put your system at risk or lead to thermal throttling? No. Even with the issues we found here, it accomplishes its job and keeps the CPU cool enough to work optimally with pretty much any CPU. And it looks good while doing it. It still shares the same installation quirks as the other HydroShift II models, but we wouldn't say to avoid it if you really like the aesthetic and the cool trick it does with its hoses. At the end of the day, this AIO serves the showcase PC builder and gamer who wants a stunning CPU cooler in their system, but isn't necessarily chasing the performance leader. If that's you, again, this is a pretty AIO that really does have some great fans. But if you don't care about the fans and you love the aesthetic, but you need to pinch the budget a little harder, the cheaper and still pretty HydroShift II 360 CL will save you a few bones without costing you much in performance. And with our opinion shared, we've come to the end of our video and we turn it over to you. What do you think of the 360 TL as the flagship for the HydroShift II? And is it worth spending extra for knowing you get the better fans for it? Let us know down in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, go ahead and slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so that you get a notification each and every time you post a video like this, either here at Robeytech or over at Robeytech Live. And if you want to continue the conversation, maybe you want to talk more about other AIOs that you might like or installing this one, head over to our Discord server, discord.gg/Robeytech. It's an amazing place to talk to other tech and PC enthusiasts about stuff like this. And you know what? You might just make a friend. Also, make sure you follow Robeytech on all your other favorite social media platforms. Thank you so much for making it this far. Thank you for your support, and we look forward to seeing you on the next video.